Hey guys, so for number 31, we're going to perform the indicated operation and simplify. And it looks like we have a complicated question here. So we're going to try and simplify this first, and then we're actually going to divide it. So to start off with, the first numerator that we have here is z squared plus 13z plus 36. So we're going to go ahead and factor that because factoring is a way of simplifying. So if we have a trinomial and it can be factored, it can always factor into two binomials. Because this z squared here has a coefficient of 1, I'm just going to separate my z's, and then I'm going to look for two factors that multiply to equal 36 that add to equal this middle term, which is 13. So the factors of 36 are 1 and 36, 2 and 18, 3 and 12, 4 and 9, and then 6 times 6. So we're looking for two factors that also add to equal 13. So those two factors are going to be the 4 and the 9. So I'm going to write those two in here. And I'm also going to double check to make sure that's right by multiplying these two together and multiplying these two together and adding them to see if that equals the middle term that I have here, which it is. So that tells us that we have the correct factors. So the factored form of my first numerator is z plus 4 and z plus 9. Now let's do the denominator. So we have z squared so same thing, if you have a trinomial and it's factorable, it can factor into two binomials. My z squared here has a coefficient of 1, so I'm just going to split my z's, and then I'm going to look for two numbers that multiply to make my 63 that also add to make my 16 over here. So my factors of 63 are 1 and 63, 3 and 21, and 7 and 9. So I need factors that also add to make 16. So that's going to be 9 and 7. So I'm going to write that in my two bubbles here, plus 9 and plus 7. And then I'm also going to double check, make sure that's right. So by multiplying these two and multiplying these two and then adding these two together, if that makes 16z, which it does, then we have the right factors. So it looks like the factored form of the denominator in the first fraction is z plus 9 and z plus 7. Let's do the numerator of the second fraction. So we have z squared plus 4z. So when you're factoring binomials, you're just taking out a GCF. Here, the GCF is just z because that's the greatest common factor I can take out, and I'm left with z plus 4. Finally, let's do the denominator in the second fraction. Once again, if you have a trinomial and it's factorable into two binomials. My z squared here has a coefficient of 1, so I'm just going to split that. And now I'm going to look for factors of 35, negative 35, that also add to make positive 2. So factors of 35 are 5 and 7 and 1 and 35. Now, because this 35 is negative, this could be negative 5 and positive 7, or positive 5 and negative 7, and this could be negative 1 and positive 35, or 1 and negative 35. So I'm looking for factors that also add up to 2, so that it's going to be negative 5 and positive 7. So I'm going to write that in my two bubbles, negative 5, positive 7, and then I'm also going to double check that that is correct by multiplying these two and multiplying those two. And if that gives me 2z, which it does, then we have the correct factors. Okay, now you have the option of simplifying the fractions individually. What I mean by that is you can simplify what you can from this fraction, and then you can simplify what you can from this fraction. So from this fraction, we both have a factor of z plus 9 on the numerator and the denominator. So those can cancel out. And then on the second fraction, we can't do anything. We can't cancel out anything. Now, you can't simplify diagonally because this is not a multiplication symbol. It's a division symbol. So in order to accomplish this operation, we have to change that to a multiplication symbol. So we're going to use the stay, change, flip method, which is a method you can use when you're dividing fractions. So here I'm going to stay with this first fraction, and then I'm going to change the division sign into a multiplication sign, and then I'm going to flip this fraction. Now I can simplify diagonally. And it looks like I can simplify the z plus 4s, and I can simplify the z plus 7. So I actually don't need to multiply because I don't have any more factors here that can multiply into factors here. Here I'm just left with a 1. Over a 1, which just makes 1. So technically this says 1 times z minus 5 over z. So my answer is z minus 5 over z. And that looks like this.